Ministry of Health recently gazetted Pelenyo Beach in Entebbe to test travelers returning to the country in a bid to fight COVID-19. But what exactly happens at the center when one gets in? Our reporter visited the facility and compiled this report.
This is Pelenyo Beach in Entebbe that was gazetted by the Ministry of Health in conjunction with Uganda Civil Aviation Authority to test travelers returning into the country. According to Andrew Nsawoteba, the coordinator of the testing operation, the travelers returning from Category 2 countries must undergo tests since these countries have more COVID cases. Upon arrival at Entebbe International Airport, the Ministry of Health team separates travelers depending on the country of origin, vaccination status, and the time of their departure.
Upon arrival at the Entebbe International Airport, at arrivals, the Ministry of Health team segregates travelers based on country of origin, the vaccination status, plus also the time of their departure from Uganda. The time someone left Uganda to a given country and them coming back. Those that are not coming from Category 2 countries, non-Category 2 countries, or they have been fully vaccinated, or have left the country within 72 hours, or have returned from abroad within 72 hours from departure.
While at this testing center, travelers raised a number of complaints, including money extortion before they are tested for COVID. If someone tests positive, they are quarantined by the Ministry of Health and the person has to foot the bills. However, the Ministry of Health coordinator in charge of the operation, Andrew Nsawoteba, disregards the extortion allegations.
Payment booths. We have a total of 4 payment booths. Payments can be done using cash, using mobile money, or Visa, what they call point of sale. The cost of a test is 250,000 shillings.
This place used to work on over 400 travelers every day, but now this number has reduced to 100. The expert explains the cause of the declining numbers.
We work on an average of about 200 travelers. The numbers have gone on to reduce. In fact, we have some days where we worked on about 110 or even 100. But the maximum number that we've handled in a day was 447. That was the maximum number before the lockdown.
However, people in the operation are facing a number of challenges in enforcing this exercise, including forgery of vaccination certificates, abuse, and all other sorts of challenges.
Violent travelers. We had a recent case where a traveler broke a point of sale machine, tore a receipt book, and even threatened bodily harm to one of my staff in this place. The other challenge is, till date, even though Uganda Civil Aviation Authority and the airport authorities have tried to ensure that airlines communicate travelers before they come in here pertaining to the operation, plus the recent media coverages that we've seen, even the
Vianne Luja, the public relations officer of the Civil Aviation Authority, says they have revised all measures, such as reducing the number of hours waiting for the results from 120 hours to 72 hours, among other measures.
We have revised some of the regulations that were previously in place, and these have been communicated to airlines and passengers. One of these is the reduction in the number of hours for the validity of the PCR test from 120 hours to 72 hours. For those coming into the country, therefore, we expect that from the time of sample collection to the time of boarding aircraft coming to Uganda is 72 hours. Similarly, on departure, we require 72 hours from time of sample collection to time of boarding aircraft departing Uganda.
This story was compiled by Godfrey Sempija for the News in Entebbe.